Hey guys, welcome to this video. Today we are going to study about how we can define our member function outside of class. Okay guys, let's take an example for understanding how we can define our member function out of class. Suppose we are asked to write a class array that contains an array of integers to store 5 values. It also contains fill function to fill the array with values, and it contains a max and min function to calculate the maximum value in the array and minimum value in the array. Okay guys, let's get started. First of all, we will declare our class, write class keyword, then the name of our class is array, and in braces we will define our private data members. We have an array of 5, length 5, so int a of 5, so we have array of 5 values. Now we will define our public member functions. Why public? Because we have to access them outside of the class. First function is to fill array. Our second function will return maximum value in the array, so its return time it will be int max function, and third function is int min function to calculate the minimum value. It will calculate and return the minimum value. Okay guys, let's define our functions outside the class. See, I am defining these functions outside of class. How we can define our member function outside of class? Simply write the return type of function, then the name of our class, that is array, and then scope resolution operator, and then the name of our function. First we have to fill the array, so fill array. Here we will prompt the user to enter 5 values. Enter 5 values. Scene a of I. We have 2 input values, 5 values, so we can use loop for int I is equal to 0, I is less than 5, and I plus plus. Here we will input 5 values, a of I. So this is our function to fill the array. Our second function is to calculate the maximum value in the array. So return type of function is int, and we have to access this member function outside of class, so we will write the class name. So our class name is array, and then so scope resolution operator, and the name of our function, that is max, and here we will calculate the maximum value in the array. I am supposing that the value at first index is the maximum value. Then we have to use for loop to iterate through the array to check the maximum value. I is equal to say 0, because array index always start from 0. I is less than 5, एंड सेमी कोलन आई प्लस प्लस. नाउ वी हैव टू चेक द फॉर मैक्सिमम वैल्यू. इफ एम इज लेस देन ए ऑफ आई देन व्हाट वी विल डू. एम इज इक्वल टू ए ऑफ आई. What I did is, I considered that the first index value, ray first element is the greatest, largest element, maximum value. Then I used for loop to iterate through the array to check if any other value is greater than this value. If this value is less than any other value, if this first index value is less than any other value, it means that value is the maximum value. So I have assigned that value to m. So this loop will iterate 5 times, and if any value if this value is less than any other value, then that value will be assigned to our variable m. M for maximum means that value will be maximum. So in this way we can calculate our maximum value. Then here, after the body of loop, I have to return my maximum value, because the return type of a function is int. So we will return return. So we will return our maximum value. So this function will return a m, that will be maximum value, because return type of function is m, int. So it will return a integer value. Similarly, we can calculate the minimum value. Again, return type of function is int, and then the name of our class, that is array, then scope resolution operator, then the name of our function is min, and here we will define the body. Again, we are supposing that m is for minimum value. We are supposing that first index value is the minimum value, and then I will iterate through this array to check, to compare other values. So I is less than 5 semicolon I plus plus. So if m is greater than a of I, means if our m is a minimum, m mean minimum, if our this minimum, let's call it minimum, and let's call this variable maximum. So there will be no confusion. Error is showing. To replace this variable name on each place, simply right click on this rename maximum. What is not maximum? Okay, undefined. So we have to replace. It is not allowing me to. So we can simply copy paste it. Control C, Control V, and here Control V, but remove this int here and also remove this int here. Okay, one thing is to move back to paste. Right click on it, rename, new name, right here the new name, that is MGM Maximum. So, apply and it will be changing. Here we have write minimum. If minimum is greater than this, means if minimum is greater than any other value in the array, that it means the minimum is not, our minimum is not minimum. If minimum is greater than any other value, that means that value is the minimum value. So we will assign that value to our minimum variable. Minimum will be equal to minimum will be equal to f I, that index value will be our minimum value. What I did is I simply declared a minimum variable and I assigned the first element of array to this variable. I am considering that my first index value is the minimum value. Then I am iterating through the loop to check if minimum is greater than any other value in the array. If our minimum is greater than any other value in the array, that means that value is the minimum value. So I have assigned that value to our minimum. Now we have to return this minimum value. Okay guys, let's call this function over here. So here we will create an object of our array of our class to call this function. So now by using this object we can access our function. So dot fill array, first we have to fill the array, then we have to calculate the maximum value in our array. So max, our max function, it will return the maximum value. Notice one thing, we are not displaying this value in our max function, simply returning. So it will return maximum value, it will not display this value. So in order to display this value, we have to display it over here. Cout maximum value is left right end of line. So we have displayed, we are calling this function, this function will return maximum value. So the maximum value is here, maximum value will be shown because this function will return the, is returning a maximum value. Next we have to display the minimum value. Minimum value is obj dot our main function. where would we have to end our line. Okay guys, in this way we can display the maximum and minimum value. Okay, let's execute this program. Enter 5 values, 12, 13, 14. So the maximum value is 90 and the minimum value is 12. See, our maximum value in array element is 90, yes, and minimum value is 12, yes. So our program is working correctly. So calculate the maximum value. What I did is simple. I consider that my first element is the maximum value in the array. Then I am comparing this first element with all other element to check that if any other value is greater than this value, then that value will be our maximum value. So if I am checking if maximum is less than any other value, I am checking that if 12 is less than any other value, then that value will be our maximum value. So see, 13 is greater than 12, so 13 will be assigned to this condition, is becomes true, and 13 is assigned to this maximum. Similarly, for 51 is greater than 13, so this 51 will be assigned to maximum. Similarly, 47 less, so this statement will not be executed, and 90 is greater than 51, so 90 is assigned to this maximum, because we are checking that if our maximum is less than this, so 51 is less than 90, so this value 90 will be assigned to our maximum value. So in this way we are calculating maximum value. Simply, I have declared a maximum variable and I have assigned the first index value, that is 12, to this maximum variable. Then I am using for loop, int I is equal to 0, I is less than 5, yes, I contains 0, 0 is less than 5, yes. So control enter the body of the loop, and maximum is less than, maximum contains 12 is less than AFI. AFI means AF 0, 12. So 12 is less than 12, no. So this condition becomes false. So the control will come here, and here our loop is terminating. The control will again shift here and increment the value of I. So I becomes 1, y 1 is less than 5, yes. So 12 is less than AF 1. So 0 index, first index 13, yes, 12 is less. So I have assigned this 13 to maximum. Now maximum contains 30. Again increment the value of I. I becomes 2, 2 is less than 5, yes. So 13 is less than AF 2. AF 2 contains 0, 1, 2, 51, yes, 13 is less than. So assign this 51 to maximum. So now maximum contains 51. Again increment the value of I becomes 3, so 3 is less than 5, yes. Maximum 51 is less than AF3, AF3 contains 0, 1, 2, 3, 47. So 51 is less than 47, no. So the condition becomes false, so the control skip this statement and come here. Again increment the value of I, that is 3, now I becomes 4, 4 is less than 5, yes. So 51 is less than AF4, AF4 contains 90. So see, 0 index, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 index contain 90. So 51 is less than 90, yes. This condition becomes true, so 90 is assigned to our maximum variable. So now maximum contains 90. Again increment the value of I becomes 5, 5 is less than 5, so the condition becomes true, false, because 5 is not less than 5. So our control will come here, skip the body of the loop, and jump here down the body of, after the body of loop, and return this maximum value. So maximum contains 90. So our this function will can return us 90. So here when we'll call this function, it will return 90. So see here, maximum value is, and this we are calling this function, so it is returning us 90. Similarly, I have calculated the minimum value using the same logic. See here, in our min function, instead of using less symbol, I am using greater symbol. I am checking if our minimum is greater than any other value. It means that value is the minimum value, because minimum cannot be greater than any other value. So okay guys, how to access the function outside the array? How to define our member function outside the array? Simply write the name of our array. How to access the member function outside of our class? Simply write the name of our class. So name of our class is array. Return type of function, then the name of our class, then scope resolution operator, then the name of our function. Sorry, not array, class. How to define our member function outside of our class? Simply write the return type of function, then the name of our class, that is array, and then the scope resolution operator, then the name of our function. So in this way we can define our member function outside of class. Okay guys, this is for this video. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to Programming Languages. Goodbye.